हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू नागेश करजगी ऑर्किड स्कूल्स चैनल। आई मिस नेहल माने टीचिंग यू साइंस मैथ्स फॉर ग्रेड 6। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द डिविजिबिलिटी रूल्स, डिफरेंट डिविजिबिलिटी रूल्स। इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू अबाउट द डिविजिबिलिटी रूल्स। सो लेट अस सी डिविजिबिलिटी बाय 11। A number will be divisible by 11 if the difference between the sum of the digits at its odd places and that of the digits at the even places is divisible by 11. As if a number is of 4 digit or 5 digit, we have to take its odd places first and then do the sum. Then we have to take the even places and then do the sum. We have to add, and whatever the result we are getting, we have to subtract it. If the difference is either 0 or multiple of 11, if the difference is 0 or multiple of 11, then the number is said to be divisible by 11. Then the number is said to be divisible by 11. Let us see example. Now see, we have the number. This is the number. It's a 5 digit number. Now first of all, we have to take its odd places. Now you can see here, it's a 5 digit number. This is the first place. This is the second place. This is the third place, fourth place and fifth place. So first, third and fifth are its odd places, and the second and fourth are its even places. So first we are going to find the sum of digits at odd places. So 5 plus 4 plus 3, so it's 5 plus 4 plus 3, we got the answer as 12. When we added the sum of the digits at odd places. Now we are going to add the digits at even places. So 0 plus 1, sum of the digits at even places, 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. Now we got the answer for sum at odd places and sum at even places. Now the result, whatever we obtain, we have to subtract it, find the difference. So difference is equal to 12 minus 1, odd minus even. So 12 minus 1, it's 11. According to our rule, if the difference is 0 or the multiple of 11, now 11 is the multiple of 11, so the number is divisible by 11. So the number is divisible by 11. So this was the example. And if the difference is like 9, 10, which are not divisible by 11, so the number will also not divisible by 11. Okay, so let us see a few more rules of divisibility. Divisibility by 3. If the sum of the digits is multiple of 3, then the number is divisible by 3. If sum of the digits is multiple of 3, then the number is divisible by 3. For example, let us see, we have a number. Now let us take the number 324. We have to find whether the given number is divisible by 3 or no. So in order to find out that, we have to add these three digits, three numbers. So we are going to add 3 plus 2 plus 4, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 3, 9, 6 plus 3 is 9. Now tell me students, whether 9 is divisible by 3? Yes, 9 is divisible by 3. So the given number 324 is divisible by 3. Okay. Now in the same way, if we have the another number and whose answer after addition is 8, which is not divisible by 3. So the number is not divisible by 3. Let us see the next divisibility rule. Divisibility by 6. If the number is divisible by 2 and 3, then the number is divisible by 6. If the number is divisible by 2 and 3, then the number is divisible by 6. Let us see example to understand this divisibility rule. Now we have the number 124. Okay, we have a 3 digit number, that is 124. So according to the divisibility rule of 6, if the number is divisible by 2 as well as 3, then the number is divisible by 6. So first we will find out whether the given number is divisible by 2 or no. So to find the given number is divisible by 2 or no, we have to see its ones place. If in its ones place we have the numbers like 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Now we have here 4, which is divisible by 2. So the given number is divisible by 2. The given number is divisible by 2. Okay, now we have to find the given number whether it is divisible by 3 or no. So in addition, we have to find the addition. So 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 2 6 plus 1 7. Okay, now the addition is 7, which is not divisible by 3, which is not divisible by 3. So 124 is not divisible by 3, is not divisible by 3. So therefore 124 is not divisible by 6, is not divisible by 6. Okay, students, listen carefully. We have the number 124. We have to find divisibility rule of 6. Okay, so what is the divisibility of 6? What is the rule? According to the rule, the number should be divisible by 2 as well as 3. So we have find out the number is divisible by 2 as it has 4 in its ones place, and the number is not divisible by 3 because after addition we are getting 7, and 7 is not divisible by 3. So the number is divisible by 2, but the number is not divisible by 3. Hence the number is not divisible by 6 because it is not satisfying the rule. So it's not divisible by 6. If we got the another number and the number is divisible by both 2 as well as 3, then we can say the number is divisible by 6. Okay, so these were the examples and these were the divisibility rules we have seen for different numbers like 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10 and 11. So let us solve examples. Now see here students, I'll explain you one, remaining you can do it. Okay, see, using divisibility test, determine which of the following numbers are divisible by 2, by 3, by 4, by 5, 6, 8, 9, 10 and 11. See, few numbers are given here and we have to see whether the number is divisible by the following numbers or no. So first we have the number which is 3 digit 128, and we have to find the divisibility rule for these many numbers. So 128, whether it is divisible by 2, can anyone of you tell me? Yes, it's divisible by 2. Why? Because we have 8 in its ones place. 8 in its ones place. So the number 2 is divisible by, the number 128 is divisible by 2 because we have 8 in its ones place, which satisfy the rule of divisibility by 2. So it is divisible by 2. Now let us find the divisibility rule for 3. So whether the given number is divisible by 3, to find out we have to add this. So 8 plus 2, 10. 10 plus 1, 11. Whether the number 11 is divisible by 3? Whether the number 11 is divisible by 3? No, it's not divisible. So 128 is not divisible by 3. Is not divisible by 3. Now we have to find the same number whether it is divisible by 4 or no. So what is the rule for 4? If the number formed by last two digits, that is ones and tens, is divisible by 4, then that number is divisible by 4. Now you can see here the ones and tens place, 28. Whether 28 is divisible by 4? Yes, 28 is divisible by 4. So the number is divisible by 4. Okay, so the next is 5. Whether the number is divisible by 5, we have to find out. So according to the divisibility rule of 5, the ones place should have 0 or 5. Ones place should have 0 or 5. So we don't have 0 as well as 5. So number 128 is not divisible by 5. Okay, next is 6. What is the divisibility rule for finding whether the given number is divisible by 6 or no? So if the number is divisible by both 2 as well as 3, so the number can be divisible by 6. Okay, so let us see. It is divisible by 2, but it's not divisible by 3. So it's not satisfying the rule. So 6, 128 is not divisible by 6. Let us see the next one, divisibility by 8. If the number formed by last three digit is actually divisible by 8, then that number is divisible by 8. Okay, can you tell me 128 whether it is divisible by 8? So let us see that 128. Okay, 8 2s are 60, so it doesn't go. So we'll take the previous number, that is 8 1s are 8. Okay, now we have to do 12 minus 8, so it's 4, and here it's, we take this down. Okay, so we get 48. So we have 48 in 8's table. Yes, 8 6 are 48. So we get the answer is 16, and it's completely divisible by 8. So number 128 is divisible by 8. So number 128 is divisible by 8. Okay. So next is 9. So let us see for 9, what is the divisibility rule? If sum of the numbers is divisible by 9, then the number itself is divisible by 9. In order to find out 9, what is the rule? We have to add it. 8 plus 2, 10. 10 plus 1, 11. 11, whether it is divisible by 9? No, it's not divisible by 9. So number 9 we have to cross out. So 128 is not divisible by 9. Now let us see it for 10. See, for finding the divisibility rule of 10, ones place should have 0. We should have 0 in its ones place. So we don't have here, and so then 10 is also, 10 also we have to cross out here, because we have 8 in its ones place, not 0. Okay, let us see next one, 11. Now as we have seen for 11, we have 128, we have to take first odd places, we have to add odd places, that is 2, no, it's 1 plus 8, 8 plus 1 is 9, okay. Then we are going to add even place. Even place, as it is three digit number, we have only one even place, that is 2. Then we have to find the difference. So 9 minus 2, 7 is the difference. Whether 7 is divisible by 11? No, it's not divisible. So 128 is again not divisible by 11. Is not divisible by 11. So these many numbers are there. You have to try it on your own. Practice it. These are the sums which are given in your textbook. So you can find out. And if you have any doubts, you are free to ask. So these were the divisibility rules that we have studied in earlier class. Now we are going to find out some divisibility test determining. Determine which of the following numbers are divisible by 4 and 8. Which of the following numbers are divisible by 4 and 8. I will explain few sums. Remaining you can practice at your home. The first one is 572. So we have to find whether the given number 572 is divisible by 4 and 8. So the rule to find whether the number is divisible by 4 is the last two digits should be divisible by 4. So whether 72 is divisible by 4? See, since last two digits, that is 72, is divisible by 4, so we can say 572 is divisible by 4. Okay, now we have to find for 8. 572 is not divisible by 8. How it is said? What is the rule to find divisibility by 8? Is if the number formed by last three digits should be divisible by 8. The three digits, we have three digit number only here. This number, when we divide, we have to see that whether it is completely divisible by 8. When we divide it, we are getting remainder, so it's not divisible by 8. So we have find out that 4 is divisible but 8 is not divisible. Okay, next the number is 6 digit. Okay, we have to find the again same 4 as well as 8. See here, since last two digits, that is 52, is divisible by 4. 52 is divisible by 4. So the number is completely divisible by 4. Let us find the divisibility rule for 8. Last three digits, that is 352. 352 is divisible by 8. So the given number is divisible by 8. 352 is completely divisible by 8. So we can tell that it's divisible by 8. Next one we will see. It's a 4 digit number, 5500. Since last two digits, that is 00, is divisible by 4. So 5500 is divisible by 4. Next we have to find for 8, last three digits, that is 500, should be divisible by 8. So the given number 500 is not divisible by 8. So we can write it as the given number is not divisible by 8. Let us see next sums. Again we have a large number here. So since last two digits, that is 72, is divisible by 4, so the number is divisible by 4. Now we have to take the last three digits, 072. 072 is divisible by 8, so the number is divisible by 8. Next, 1700. As last we have 0, it is divisible by 4. And last three digits, that is 700, it's not divisible by 8. So 1700 is not divisible by 8, but it's divisible by 4. Okay, next sum, 2150. Since last two digits, that is 50, is not divisible by 4. 50 is not divisible by 4. So 2150 is not divisible by 4. Let us see for 8. We have to take last 3 digits, that is 150. Again 150 is not divisible by 8. So the number 2150 is not divisible by 8. So in this question we have seen that to find out the divisibility rule for 4 and 8. We have seen the divisibility rule for 4 and 8. In the next sum, we will see the next divisibility rule. A few examples I have solved here and explained you. Remaining examples which were given in your textbook, you need to practice it. And if you have any doubts, you can free to ask. Okay, let us go to next question. Yes, see here. Using divisibility test, determine which of the following numbers are divisible by 6. Which of the following numbers are divisible by 6? Okay. Now few numbers are given. We have to find out whether the numbers are divisible by 6 or no. So, what is the divisibility rule for 6? Anyone of you remember that we have studied in the earlier class? Yes. If the number is divisible by 2 as well as 3, then the number is divisible by 6. So let us see. We have a 6 digit number. So since the last digit is 4, it means in its ones place we have the digit 4. So it is divisible by 2. According to the divisibility rule for 2, if the numbers like 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, if we have in its ones place, then the number is divisible by 2. So we have 4 in its ones place, and so the number can be divisible by 2. Now let us find it for 3. So to find it for 3, we have to add. See, 2 plus 9 plus 7 plus 1 plus 4 plus 4. We got the addition 27. Now tell me, is 27 divisible by 3? Yes, 27 is divisible by 3. So the number is divisible by 3. Now we got the number is divisible by 2 and also by 3. So number is divisible by both 2 and 3. So the number is divisible by 6. Okay. Let us see the next one. It's a 4 digit number. Take the last digit. We have 8 in its ones place. So it's satisfying the rule for divisibility test of 2. So if it is having 8 in its one place, the number is divisible by 2. Now we have to find for 3. We have to add it. 1 plus 2 plus 5 plus 8 is 16. Whether 16 is divisible by 3? No, 16 is not divisible by 3. So the number is divisible by 2. So the number is not divisible by 6. Okay. So this was the example to find out whether the given numbers are divisible by 6. Okay. Few more examples are there here. I will explain one or two, which are the bigger one. Now we have again 6 digit number here. Since the last digit is 52. Which are divisible by 2. Like see, the last digit, like ones place we have 2 here. So 2 is divisible by 2. So the number is divisible by 2. Now to find it of 3, we have to add 9 plus 0 plus 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 2. We got the answer as 20. 20 is divisible by 3? Whether it's divisible by 3? No. 20 is not divisible by 3. So the number is not divisible by 3. So we have find out that the number is divisible by 2 but not by 3. So the number is not divisible by 6. The number is not divisible by 6. Let us see the next one. Since the last digit is having 0. So 0, if it is having 0 in its ones place, the number is divisible by 2. The number is divisible by 2. Now to find the divisibility of by 3, we have to add it. 4 plus 3 plus 8 plus 7 plus 5 plus 0. When we add it, we get 27. Whether 27 is divisible by 3? Yes, 27 is divisible by 3. So the number is divisible by 3. Okay. Since it is divisible by both 2 as well as 3, so the number is divisible by 6. So the number is divisible by 6. Last one. It's a large number again. 7 digit number. Last digit, it's 4 in its ones place. So the given number is divisible by 2. The given number is divisible by 2. Then to find divisibility by 3, we have to do 1 plus 7 plus 9 plus 0 plus 1 plus 8 plus 4. We got 30. We got 30. Whether 30 is divisible by 3? Yes. 30 is divisible by 3. So the given number is divisible by 3. The given number is divisible by 3, as it is satisfying the rule that it is divisible by 2 and also by 3. So the given number is divisible by 6. So the given number is divisible by 6. Okay, students. Now we have seen the divisibility. In the first example, we have seen the divisibility rule for finding the given number is divisible by 4 and by 8. In the next example, we have find out the given numbers are divisible by 6. Okay. In the next class, we will find in detail about the numbers, whether they are divisible by 11 or no. In the next examples, in next class. Till that time, you all can practice the divisibility rules. Even you can write and take many different examples to find out the different divisibility rules for different numbers. So practice, students. Thank you.